Imagine what pain he was in. He was dripping with sweat. And after I'd gone about three shallows, traversed that, had there been a path or a road, I could have done better. He pummeled me, put me down. I'd rather die, put me down. I can't go any further, let me die. I said, if I leave you here, Bill, you won't be found. Let's have another go. He said, all right then. The same thing happened. He couldn't stand it anymore, and I had to leave him there in no man's land.
Thank you.
no sooner taken two or three steps down the trench when I heard, "Oh, hello, Raz, I'm glad to see you. This is my second night here." He said, "I'm feeling bad." And it was Bill Hubbard, one of the men we'd trained in England, one of the original battalion. I had to look at his wound, rolled him over, and I could see that it was probably a fatal wound. You can imagine what pain he was in. He was dripping with sweat. And after I'd gone about three shell holes, traversed that, had there been a path or a road, I could have done better. He pummeled me, put me down, I'd rather die, put me down. I was hoping he would faint. He said, "I can't go any further, let me die." I said, "If I leave you here, Bill, you won't be found. Let's have another go." He said, "All right then." The same thing happened. He couldn't stand it anymore, and I had to leave him there in no man's land.
This is the end.